Okay, thank you very much, Francisco. Hello again, I'm Miguel Ángel. And now I'm not talking about the conference, but also. I'm talking about a project that is a STEAM project that was defined, was granted last December, but we have begun in February more or less. We were in a residential little one, it's a very long story. And in that kind of project, we found a problem that is we are going to talk about challenge-based learning. But the problem with challenge-based learning is that it's very, very influenced by the context. So we are going to talk about this today and also we have found regarding. The outline I'm going to follow is this. I wrote some parts to the project. I'm going to learn some related to the project. We will talk about challenge-based learning, what is it, what kind of provide this methodology to us. And the challenge concept and how we have to adapt this kind of concept to our specific context. And some templates that we have used in the project and examples. And finally, I will post some examples. Regarding the project, but I think that it's clear for us that we need better prepared professionals. What does this mean? The idea is we need people that learn to use at least their daily technologies, at least the technologies that a company needs, at least to understand how the digital society is working. And that is not always easy. Because several issues, if you think about it, probably some of you have found that you are a teacher, you have to teach, and you have a lot of innovations, and you have to meet how to include technologies that the students are used to use in your real classes, and that's really hard. How to do this? Well, there are different possibilities. But it's interesting, in any case, to make them think, to develop some kind of competencies such as critical thinking, problem solving. I don't know, I guess you have heard about this kind of competencies. We used to say, I'm trying to foster critical thinking, problem solving. I don't know. If we are talking about knowledge, about ICT, we will talk about computational thinking. Computational thinking as one of the key competencies related with learning algorithms, learning how to use the technology and learning how to apply it in order to solve real life problems. Okay, so this is our context, but the problem is how can I develop this kind of competencies? Probably you have heard about the STEM education or STEAM education, science, technology, engineering, and maths probably later. The company said, hey, I want people that have a more I need people with creativity. I need people that look for not only the best solution, but the solution that fits properly and the solution that is more, I don't know, popular. So we are going to include also the AI. But the problem is how I can introduce this into our learning program. The problem is you can only include a subject. You can only include a set of subjects. The problem is that the STEM should be present in all the program and probably not in a specific ones. Okay. Now, I'm going to comment something. The thing is, if we need to promote this, we need flexible methodologies. Probably you have heard or used or applied these kind of methodologies. Problem-based learning and project-based learning, because it's quite common. In fact, before the people begin to talk about this, we were doing this. Okay. Because we are talking about problems and how to solve them. We are preparing them projects, working together, working in groups, developing teamwork competence, and things like that. But we are going to go beyond with challenge-based learning. The challenge-based learning is an initiative that is very flexible, that requires not only the involvement of the students, but the experts, the teachers, the parents of the students, in order to solve a real challenge, something more near to the reality. And we need to foster this in a way in which the students can touch the solution. This is important, not only to develop a solution to a challenge, but they can feel the solution as if it is as something of them, and also to touch it. And a possibility to touch it is try to address some challenges related to robotics, okay, to robotics and physical devices. And this is more or less what we have proposed in this project. RoboSTEAM project is an Erasmus Plus funded project and strategic partnership. And what it aims is to facilitate developing computational thinking by applying challenge-based learning initiative methodologies and using to develop these physical devices and robotic kits. Okay. And we define the project, we propose it, and it was granted finally after a lot of reviews in December of this year. It involves several institutions. It involves the University of Leon as coordinator, but also the University of Salamanca, the University of Eastern Finland, Polytechnic Institute for Braganza, and several schools. And why? Because we are not talking only about theoretical frameworks to do. No, we want to apply it. And the only way to apply it is to look up for a real context. So we are including Colegio Internado dos Carvalhos do Porto, ESL de la Nueva from León, Agrupamiento de Escolas Emilio García from Braganza. And well, this is a university, the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, that is also involved, but we have another school that is Karlsruhe Institute. Also, we have as an associate partner Arduino. You know Arduino? So, Arduino is an associate partner just to say they are supporting us. They are not giving us more money, nor equipment, nothing, but they are supporting us, which is important. And why to have all this together? Because probably, we are trying to solve this, probably it's not the same to solve a challenge in Portugal than to solve a challenge in Finland. Because the way in which we teach is different, because the number of hours that you can devote to this kind of activities is different. So it is interesting to look for these differences, and that's what we are going to try. Especially taking into account that different cultures can have different ways to understand the things. You can see the slide. What is doing here, the two kisses or the kisses more in several places, this is different. In Spain, in Portugal, in Finland, in Brazil, that's a matter. So we need to look for a common point of view. Given this, we are going to connect to something about challenge-based learning. Challenge-based learning is, as I told you, a flexible methodology that looks for a way in which the students could leverage the technology they use in their daily lives to solve real world problems. What is this? They can use the mobile phones, they can use the smartwatches, they can use the laptops. Not only what you give them a common class, it's different. And if even they can use another kids and other technology that you can provide there. Probably not always using the daily lives, but also. It is a collaborative methodology. As I told you, you are going to involve students, teachers, experts. You can write to an expert, you can phone an expert, a person, and you can look for them, for their emails, and send them an email. Maybe they are not going to answer, but if they answer you, if they answer the students are going to be happier and going to learn a lot. The idea is to propose the students a big idea, something in which they can reflect or analyze. The students from this analysis should identify some main questions, main research questions. And later, by analyzing this question, define a challenge. A challenge that is going to be addressed by using the technology and by using collaborating with other people. These are most common phases of challenge-based learning. The idea is to first engage the students through the big idea, the essential questions, and the definition of the challenge, linker research outputs by the given questions we have defined, given activities and analysis, and finally act, look for the solution, implement and evaluate. It's important also to evaluate the solutions. Not we are not really sure that we are doing the things well or not. Well, it's an aspect of the world is a bit that you can see this, that we have different ideas. The idea of that the people is going to be engaged because they are doing things, we are trying to solve really real things, which is important. The idea that they are going to work not only with their peers but with experts and others. The idea that they can research, they can feel themselves working in a research, looking for the proper questions, redefining the questions, okay? And the idea of using different kind of knowledge to solve the challenges. So what we found? What we found is that we need to define the challenge concept, and the challenge concept is different for me than for others. If I can employ 20 hours, it's not the same if I can employ only 10. So we are going to define three levels of granularity. Nano challenge meaning challenge and challenge. Okay? From some nano challenges you can build a mini challenge, from some mini challenge you can build a nano challenge. A challenge comes from a big idea with 4 hours per day, 5 days per week, and 4 weeks per month. And we are talking about around 2 months. So it's around 40 hours or 60 to solve it. A mini challenge is more concrete. We have a more concrete idea. We have around 40 hours distributed as you see. Some in class and some in their free time at home. And then another challenge is much more concrete. Shorter in length and from a specific area. Probably with 6-10 class hours or for six working hours at home. This is much more near to project this level. If you define so concretely the area or the issue that we are going to deal with, this is going to be near to project. What we know as project this level. Why do this? Because we have several schools. And some of our schools have 2 days at the week for working with this, but only 1 hour. And some of us have 3 hours or 4 hours. And it's completely different. If you are trying, and if you are going to apply, as Jorge is going to comment later, a summer campus, it is going to be also different because they are going to have much more time to deploy to this. So we need to find a common point to do this and a common way to describe it. Here we have to find some templates, some for the challenges, for instance, challenges improve transportation, and it's a challenge depending on the vehicles that employ fossil fuels and how this helps reduce this. Some goals and some evaluation. This could be detailed in some mini challenges. I don't know why, but it's not. Well, and we have templates for mini challenges and we have defined templates for the nano challenges. The idea of mini challenge could be the use of robotics to solve this kind of problem. And the idea of a nano challenge would be a specific problem to be solved by the robot, such as the one Joseph is going to show us. That is, for instance, to follow a line, which is a problem related with the delivery of the delivery of objects. So, as a conclusion, I would like to say we need to be flexible enough to allow all the features of the specific context and the features of our experience. And we need to take into account that this is not easy. And looking for ways to solve this is what we are doing in our role team project. That's all, because if not, he's going to show me the rest of the class, so I prefer to finish it. Thank you.